Hello friends and welcome to our channel The Teacher. In this Word 2016 tutorial video, we will learn about setting up page margins and indents in Word documents. Moreover, we will discuss about the difference between using page margins and indents and how the section breaks can be helpful when working on complex documents. The page margin, indents and section breaks are related to each other, and that is why we are covering all these three topics in a single lesson. So stay tuned as we will be right back with this interesting lesson. Welcome back. My name is Rajiv, and as I said earlier, we will be discussing about indents, margins and section breaks. So before I tell you about indents, let's first talk about the page margins, so you may clearly understand the difference between margins and indents. Margins are the blank space around the edges of the page, as you can see on the screen, where from all the four sides of the paper, blank space has been left. Generally, most of the time you will be working inside the printable area between the margins. However, you can still position some items in the margins area like headers, footers or page numbers, even some graphic elements like pictures, shapes or world art. When you first open a blank document in Word 2016, and then if you click on Layout tab and click the Margins drop-down button, then you will find that the default margins for a new document are set to Normal, where 1-inch blank space has been left around all the four edges of the paper. If you wish to increase or decrease the page margins, then you can either use any of these predefined margins from the list, or you can totally take control over the margins by applying custom margins, and there you can choose that how much space you want to leave blank on what side of the paper. Like for this particular document, I want 0.5 inches from top and bottom each, 1.5 inches from left and 1 inch from right. And in the preview pane below, you can notice the changes as I am typing different values in the given boxes. Below the preview pane, you can see an Apply To drop-down menu, where for the time you have two options, Whole Document or This Point Forward. As the name suggests Whole Document, and which is also selected by default, the set margins will be applied to all the pages of this particular document. Let's first apply the changes and see the effect. As you can see that each page of this document now has the same margins, and the same blank area on all four sides of page edges has as on the first page, because the set margins are being applied to the whole document. Even though you can apply different set of margins for separate pages of your document, and we will talk about this later in this video. So how much margins could be perfect for your document? Actually, that is not fixed at all. It totally depends on you and the contents in your document. Sometimes you might want to leave much wider space over the paper edges, and sometimes a teeny amount of margins could be sufficient. Before I go and tell you about the second option which was available in margins window, Apply To This Point Forward, let's first learn about the indents and section breaks so you can better understand this concept. Before section breaks, let's first talk about the indents. Indent is used to separate a paragraph from left or right margins. In Microsoft Word, there are a total of three types of indents: the first line indent, left indent, and the right indent. I have also discussed this in my previous video that most of the time I have seen many users who press the Enter key to move to the next line even though they were writing a paragraph. This is because they didn't want to write a wider paragraph using the entire available space up to the right margin. So to shorten it, they press the Enter key, and as I said in my previous videos, it is not a right way to type or shorten a paragraph. In Microsoft Word, whenever you press the Enter key, Word assumes that you are beginning a new paragraph. So, how indents can help you in this regard and how they are different from margins? The next time, whenever you need to adjust a paragraph, you can easily accomplish this by adjusting the indents alone. Before we go and start working with indents, keep in mind that the indents are only visible on the ruler. And if you are not seeing any ruler on the screen, then you can enable ruler by clicking on View tab from the ribbon and then make a check mark on ruler from the Show section. Now, select a paragraph, and if you want to shorten it, Let's say that you want that particular paragraph to end 1 inch before the right margin, then just grab the right indent bar and move it to the left side. That's how easy it is to adjust a paragraph, and you no more longer need to press enter key in the end of each line to shorten the paragraph. In the same way, if you want to move a particular paragraph from the left side, adding to the left margin, then first select that paragraph. Then move your mouse pointer over the blow handler, and when you see a tooltip displaying left indent, hold down the left click and then move your mouse to the right side to add an extra space with left margin. We usually add left indent with left margin if there are some quotes written in your document to highlight them separately, as the one you can see in the predefined styles. You can also note that, however, I am moving the left indent alone, but the first line indent is also getting moved along with the left indent. Now let's talk about the first line indent. If you place your cursor in the beginning of a paragraph and then press the tab key once, then Word will add 1/2 inch space in the beginning while moving only the first line 1/2 inch further. Then you can also notice in the ruler that the first line indent slider has automatically moved 1/2 inch further. It is automatically done as Word assumed that you want to add some extra space to the first line of the paragraph. It is the quickest method to adjust the first line indent, but when you need to add first line indents for many paragraphs, then you can select all of them and then just move the first line indent alone from the ruler to add some extra space for the first line of paragraphs. A few times, you might want the first line to remain close to the left margin, but want to increase left indent alone. Then you can move the indents like this. So, this is how you can use indents to adjust the paragraph contents quickly instead of pressing extra spaces, tab keys, or hitting enter in the end of each line of a paragraph. So, the difference between the page margins and indent is that the page margins are applied to a particular page or a section, whereas the indents can be applied on a particular selected paragraph or a line. To apply different indent settings for different paragraphs, you don't even need section breaks. You can simply define different indent settings for different paragraphs or lines just by selecting them. But what if you want to have different margins for different pages in your document? Let's say that you want narrow margins for the first page of your document and then normal margins for the rest of the pages. This is when the section breaks comes to handy. Do note that if I just go and apply any of predefined margins from the margins drop-down button, then that particular margins will get automatically applied to the whole document unless you have inserted section breaks. Section breaks help you to customize the layout and formatting of your document when you need different configuration for different pages, like you need one page in portrait mode and the second page in landscape, or you want to apply narrow margins for the first page and normal margins on the second page. Even you can apply different header and footer for different set of pages, or different page numbers for different chapters in your document. Section breaks are also useful, like when you need to change the number of columns on the same page without starting a new page. These are just a few examples, as section breaks can help you to completely take control over your document consisting hundreds of pages. In my opinion, when you insert a section break, it tells Microsoft Word to start a whole new environment, just like a blank document from the cursor position. I mean, when you insert a section break, then right from the cursor position, a whole new section begins, and then you can redefine everything from start, like different page layout, margins, header footers, page columns, page numbers, and the previous pages in your document will remain unbroken. Now let's see an example. As I said earlier that I want to apply different margins for different pages, first I move to the beginning of this document and then I click on narrow from the margins drop down button, and instantly those margins will be applied to the entire document. Now I move to the second page and here I choose custom margins and then define the margins as required, let's say 1 inch from all four sides. From apply to drop down menu, I choose this point forward and then apply the changes, and there you have different margins for both pages. Do note that I have not inserted any section breaks yet. Then how Microsoft Word applied separate margins to both pages? When you select this point forward from the margins window, then Word automatically inserts a section break at the cursor position. Section breaks are not visible by default. So if you want to see them, then you need to turn on Show Height feature from the Home tab from the paragraph section. And there it is. You can insert section breaks at any given point at right from that position. Word will let you redefine almost everything, and it is not necessary that you always insert section breaks in the end or beginning of a page. You can start a new section from anywhere. By default, in Word 2016, there is no indication on the status bar that on which section you are currently working on. So, if you want to see the section numbers alongside the page numbers, then you can right click on an empty space of the status bar and then make a check mark on section. And then the section numbers will start appearing on the status bar. As we just discussed about the this point forward option under the page setup window, you might see the same option in various other Microsoft Word settings, like when using columns from the layout tab, or while applying page border from the design tab. This point forward automatically inserts section breaks, so you can apply different layout and formatting from that point onwards. But most of the times, you might want to insert a section break alone without using any other command from the ribbon. So, to insert a section break at a given point or right at your cursor position, click the Layout tab and then click Breaks from the Page Setup section. From the Breaks drop-down button, below you have four different choices for section breaks. When you use this point forward while using any given command, continuous section breaks are used, which start a whole new section right from the cursor position. But sometimes you might want to start a new section on the next page instead on the same page. Then you can use next page section break. Like from this point forward, if I want to move everything to the next page and want to begin a new section, then instead of moving by hitting some extra enter keys, I will insert a next page section break while positioning my cursor at that point. And you can see that everything from the cursor position moved to the next page, and section break has been inserted. For this particular page, if I want the page orientation to be landscape, then I can change this from the layout tab. But the previous page will remain intact, and then you can continue to insert more section break as per requirement for next pages. Now let's see another example of section breaks. In this particular document, from the second paragraph onwards, I want to have two columns on this page. So, while pointing my cursor in the beginning of the second paragraph, I first insert a continuous section break from the layout tab. As we now have a new section from the cursor position, I can have two columns on my page from this point forward by applying two columns from the columns drop-down in the layout tab. And there will now be two columns in the rest of the document except for the first paragraph. From this position onwards, I insert a column break to move rest of the contents to the next column. And then from this point onwards, I want to have three columns. Then again, I first insert a continuous section break here because I want the contents to remain on the same page. And then I can assign three columns using the same command. So, using the same method, I can have different column layout on the same page. Two more section breaks type that you can use are odd and even page section breaks. In this Android project file, what I want is to begin this Android operating system chapter to start from the next odd page, and for now, it is on even page. Here you need to note down the page number in the header of the page where it has page number 2. And in the status bar, the document page itself is on an even page, which is page number 2. Now, if I go and insert an odd page section break, then you can immediately notice that not only the page number in the header has changed, but the page itself moved to the odd page. And that you can guess from the page number in the status bar. But what interesting to note here is, if I scroll up, then you can see that there has nothing changed between the both two pages. Only the header and the page number has changed. But how? Let's see the print preview. In the print preview, you can see that Word inserted a blank page between the both pages, and which is only visible in the print preview. And in normal print layout mode, you will see no difference. And it seems that Word moved that particular page to an old page. But in the background, that is how Microsoft Word doing this, by inserting a blank page between the pages, so that particular page may become an old page. Let's have another example. Let's say I want to have history chapter page on an old page. Then I will place my cursor on the top of the page and will then insert an old page section break. And there you have that chapter on an old page. Same way, if I want that Android version history chapter to begin on next even page, because the next page, page number 7, is an old page, and if I manually move it by pressing some extra enter keys or by inserting a next page section break, then it will be on an old page, page number 7. But I want it on the next even page. Let's undo this first. What I will do is to insert an even page section break. You can see the print preview to guess what Microsoft Word is doing to adjust those pages, and that is by inserting a blank page in the background. So this is how the page margins, indents and section breaks work. I hope you may now have a good understanding about these Microsoft Word commands. If you think this video was informative and interesting, then don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Do leave your comments and suggestions. Move to our channel page to watch some more of our videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.